our hymn number, I Need Thee, every hour. How many people need the Lord every hour? We as diocese, we as black community, we as brown community, we as Caucasian community, we as the world need the Lord. The altars on the shrine.
members. I have a special appeal for the congregation. If you truly believe that the Lord can answer prayers, then my appeal is that you will pray right now for Brother Carl Profader. He was here during the worship experience, but he has been rushed to the hospital. How many people know that God answers prayer? So as we go to the throne of grace, we want to ask that God will move mightily on behalf of Brother Carl. I'm going to ask that you will join me in celebrating God's continued healing for Brother Jimmy Brown. I visited with him yesterday, and he's recuperating well. And prayerfully, God will allow him to go home to further his recuperation. And there are others that are listed on our sick and shut in list. God has raised up Sister Marlo Surratt, and she's in the house of the Lord. But we ask you pray for Sister Marilyn Johnson, who is in need of divine healing, and others that you know that are close in heart. So let us go to the throne of grace and be earnest in our prayers. The prayer of the righteous does avail much. As we humbly go to the throne of grace. Eternal God, we're grateful for this beautiful day that you have made, this wonderful, glorious day that you have made, and you've given us the ability to see it with our eyes and participate in it. We thank you, Abba Father, the great I am that I am, El Shaddai, Elohim, Yahweh. And Heavenly Father, we come on bended knees and humble hearts. We come into this worship experience like David declared, led to be in the house of the Lord one more time. We didn't come out of any form or fashion, but we didn't come out of any historical event, but we come, dear God, because we know truly where our help comes from. Our help comes from you, God Almighty. Omnipotent, knowing what we stand in need of, even before we ask. We come, El Shaddai, Elohim, Yahweh, casting our cares on you, knowing you care so very much for us. Thank you, God, for all who have come to the altar, lifting up their concerns to you. Truly, they are looking to the hills from which cometh their help, knowing that all of their help comes from you above. So, God, we ask that you will not only hear their prayer, but that you, God, will answer their prayer. It's us, dear God. It's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. And as we come, dear God, we acknowledge not only do we need you every hour, we need you every minute, every moment, every second of the day. We come, dear God, and according to your word, you said, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek God's face and turn from their wicked ways, then you will heal from heaven and heal the land. We ask, dear God, that you forgive us of any sin, any thought, word, or deed that we have done not pleasing in your eyesight, and that you will forgive our sins and hear our prayer as we come to pray for this United States, that we will be united in purpose under one God, indivisible, but serving you in spirit and in truth. We pray for the tearing down of racism and the building up of peace for all nations and all colors of people's skin. We just ask your God that you will move in a mighty special way. Move from the mountaintops, dear God, and rain down in each community, in every state, every city, every neighborhood, everywhere. anywhere, dear God. Let your Holy Spirit and your love abide. Help us, dear God, to acknowledge that we are all created in your image and that you, God, are in control of all things. As we come casting our cares, we believe by faith, dear God, that you not only hear our prayer, but right now, God, you're answering our prayer. Right now, dear God, you're healing for the far profaner, from the crown of his head to the soul of his feet. Right now, dear God, in the name of Jesus, you're removing all disease and discomfort that he's experiencing. Right now, in the name of Jesus, not only you're ministering to him, but everyone, our sick and shuddered, the brothers Jimmy Brown, Marlon Johnson, and Andy Bowen, and Michael Surratt, and everyone who is in need of your divine healing. We are truly believing by faith, dear God, the best is still yet to come, and that you can do all but fail. So God, in the name of Jesus, by your stripes, we claim your healing for every person who's in need. By your stripes, dear God, that they be able to raise up off the bed of affliction and walk to the liberty that you have set them free and free indeed. By your stripes, dear God, they're able to be in sound mind and in right spirit and able to accomplish everything given to their hands. By your stripes, dear God, that you will bring peace where there is injustice, and you will bring peace where there's war, and we will study war no more. Oh God, as we come in the name of Jesus, casting all our cares on you, believing by faith you're working all things out for our good and for your glory. Your word declares you've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor seed begged for bread. So we pray, God, for all of the young men and all the young women that are assembled here today. We pray, God, that they will fall under your authority and that you will continue to be the first in their lives and that you, God, will help them to understand their purpose and fulfilling their purpose for your glory. We pray, God, you protect their going in and their coming out, that you will help them and shield them with your bodyguards of grace and mercy, that they can rise up and be the men and women of God that you created and destined them to be. Thank you in advance, dear God, for not only hearing our prayer, but thank you in advance for answering our prayer. Because we know, dear God, that in the name of Jesus, all things are possible. In the name of Jesus, eyesight is given to the blind. In the name of Jesus, dead men have been able to walk. In the name of Jesus, women with the issue of blood can hear and walk and be set free. In the name of Jesus, we have life and life more abundantly. Thank you, dear God, for not only hearing our prayer, but thank you, God, for answering our prayer. In Jesus Christ's holy and righteous name we pray. Amen. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. As you continue in our worship experience, it's offering time.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And beloved in Christ, as we prepare to cheerfully give unto the Lord has been good to you, hasn't he?
Amen.
Here we are in the month of December, the year of 2014 is almost at the end, but we can think about God's blessings since the beginning of this year. How many people have been able to get some things done with the help of the Lord?